right now that you are in this gym, the potential fight that, you know, a lot of people that's been talking, is he is one of the prospects, future champions, Teofimo Lopez. And I know, you know, over here, Richard Commey is training.
Yeah.
How do you picture this fight between these two, fighters?
You know, right now, obviously, Richard Commey is my stablemate now. You know, and I'm very good friends with Teofimo Lopez, man. So, listen, man, that fight is up in the air, you know. They're both tremendous fighters. I mean, Teofimo, you know, he's a tremendous fighter. He just came out the Olympics. 2016, you know, Richard Commey is a world champion, so that's for itself, man. If that fight was still to happen, man, there would be fireworks.
It is. I feel like Teofimo already showed, even though people, you know, like, still criticize that he could go up to 12 rounds. Maybe even though he said it, and you know, after the fight, it was finished and everything, he said it. I didn't like the way I performed, but guess what? You know, I showed that I could go to the 12 rounds. So, and I feel like now, Teofimo's been through different tests. Richard Commey is the same thing, you know. He faced a Beltran, tough opponent. But this is one of the toughest opponents also in his career. So the question is, can Teofimo come and snatch the belt and take it with him?
You know, it's levels, man, you know, and obviously Teofimo is my boy, you know, but I feel like, you know, Teofimo, you know, could take it a little bit more easier, you know what I mean, as far as keep stepping up with the opponents, you know, keep getting that experience, that 12-round experience, you know, if it goes 12 rounds, because he's a puncher, you know, and then eventually get the shot at Richard Commey, you know what I mean, but listen, man, you know, Teofimo's still young, man, you know, he's a young guy, and, you know, I'm young, you know, so us young fighters, young. He's a contender now, but as a prospect, you know what I mean? You gotta take it easy, you know what I mean? Because at that level, anything can happen, you know? You don't wanna end your career so soon.
That is true, you know, I mean, fighters, they take in, sometimes they too much risk and take it in order to take their fights. But if they are ready in order to make that step, you know, I give it, you know, big prompts to them, because they, you know, a lot of people can say, oh, why are you fighting him when you could go to a different way and just wait until the time comes? But I guess Teofimo is, in his mind, or maybe his goal is to get those titles belts, because he's been calling a lot. Lomachenko, what do you think if he, let's say, and things go different and Teofimo will face in the future Lomachenko?
Oh, in the future, with Teofimo having more experience, it'll, like I said, it'll be a tremendous fight. You know, Teofimo's a great fighter. You know, Lomachenko's a future Hall of Famer, you know what I mean? So that fight will eventually be fought, man. Like I said, man, you know, I feel like in my heart, my boy Teofimo says, you know, take it easy, you know what I mean? It's no rush of titles, man, you know what I mean? You know, 22 years old, you know, or 21 years old, man. He's still young. You know, there's still a lot of years. You want to reserve yourself from that. You know, you don't want to jump into those type of fights and eventually having to continuously fight those elite fighters, you know, at that young age, you know what I mean?
Exactly. Representing Puerto Rico right now, I feel like a lot of young prospects from Puerto Rico are coming up, you know, and sooner. Now, you are one of the images of Puerto Rico. How you feel now every time that you step into the ring now? In order to, that you carry also, you know, Puerto Rico on your shoulders and step into the ring and perform.
Listen, man, I'm happy. I dreamed of this, you know, like I told Top Rank. You know, I was dreaming of this as a little kid, you know what I mean? So I started boxing, the same adult photo, same thing like that, doing it. Now that I'm in the position that they're in, you know, and I put my eye on my back, my flag on my back, you know, it's a blessing from God, man, you know, and there's no pressure on that, you know. Listen, man, I'm Puerto Rican, 22 years old, 6'1", 6'2", you know, 160 pounds, so I got everything in my favor, man, you know what I mean? And it's all God, and it's just all blessings, man, and I'm just blessed to be in this position, to be able to carry, like I said, my eye and my people behind my back, and there's no pressure whatsoever, man, it's just none of the blessings that's going to be coming my way.
Very good, in order that you pictured yourself to get these goals in your career, step by step, no rushing, as you mentioning. There's a lot to learn, and well, I can tell that you're ready for a world title shot, but it's not me that is going to step into the ring. Of course, it's yourself, and eventually when the time comes, you will be ready, more than ready, in order to get this this opportunity and get any belt that appears, I guess, in order that you can, you know, belong to yourself. So, would you like to send a message to fight fans and also, you know, remind your account and everything?
Continue to follow my career and all my Puerto Ricans and Puerto Rico, you know, from New York, from the city, from the whole Tri-State area. I love you guys. Continue to support me and Team Berlanga. I love you guys. Te quiero mucho, Puerto Rico.
Thank you, Edgar. We're wishing the best for you.